Okay. Next episode. Okay.
Welcome to the next episode.
Where I propose the idea that Eminem did in fact. First of all, okay. The thing is, like, just okay. Literally every like shitty rapper is like, who's their main influence?
Eminem. It's Eminem.
Literally all of them.
Yeah.
Okay. And like all the good white rappers. So when you ask them about Eminem, they're like, yeah, I'm never really into that, into his stuff. But you ask all the bad white rappers, and they're all like, yeah, Eminem.
Yo, do fucking Eminem.
Like, okay, it's just simple math.
It's simple maths.
Okay, it's just that Eminem is like all the shitty rappers are inspired by. That's my entire case
You think about all like the great white rappers, Kurt Lugoof.
Krayshawn, Be Nasty, all these people. You ask them about Eminem, they'll be like, I don't really care.
ICP, you know, actively had beef with Eminem.
Yeah, God. But you ask like shitty rappers like Machine Gun Kelly and Hopson. Hopson's not white, he might as well be.
Oh my God.
This is very white.
Every battle rapper ever. Like, they'll all be like, yeah, Eminem, my favorite rapper ever.
Yeah.
And it's like, they all suck. They're all terrible rappers.
Definitely.
I don't remember whose quote it was, but someone said, yeah, Eminem is okay for a white guy.
Wow.
Not even though.
I don't have to play devil's advocate here.
Go ahead. But
firstly, I think this is not controversial that Infinite is a good tape.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, Infinite's good, yeah.
I think that...
My actual opinion is that Eminem, like, the quote-unquote classic Eminem albums... Eminem is the worst part about them. The beats are good, generally. On average, the beats are good.
Yeah, I think that those are, like, original, like, classic Eminem, like, the first, like, two, like, well-known ones. I think that they're very lopsided. I think that there are some songs on both of them that I enjoy, but I think a lot of the songs on them are just bad.
Yeah, I like the first two. I like when Eminem is just rapping about like killing women or whatever.
Indeed. Bitch, I'm gonna kill you. Like that's a good song, but shit like Stan is annoying. It's like really fucking.
I was so into Stan when I was 13.
Everyone was. Like Baby's first fucking like deep sad song.
Yeah, it's fuck like Eminem, really bitch, what's a Stan? Dance with the Devil by Immortal Technique.
Yeah,
I'm not even really into it. It just fits my mood sometimes.
See, this is the thing. I said that in a way where I was not like blatantly targeting you, but I didn't even take it personally.
No, because you were. You just came out and you knew I wasn't gonna take it. You knew I wasn't gonna take the fucking
hand. I knew it. I predicted your move like chess.
I'm reading
fucking 20 moves ahead. I already know what you're gonna say in the next episode.
Yeah, as we've discussed, Carla, never one to back down from a challenge.
I hope you're ready for the next episode. Hey, yay. Smoke weed every day.
It's just because like Eminem, right, is like the highest selling fucking rapper ever, right?
Is that fucking true? I hate that.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's awful.
Is dead as true. He is technically the most popular rapper, most successful rapper ever.
Sucks.
If we're talking like traditionally classic, like. Hip hop albums, so like, I we would consider, I don't know,
Six like classic,
like, yeah, but I'm talking like if we're talking about classic, like, I'm talking Illmatic, I'm talking
right,
Chronic, I'm talking,
yeah, of course,
like, which ones are actually good?
Everything by Tupac is good.
Doggy Style is good. Doggy Style is really good.
Doggy Style is actually god tier.
The Chronic is god tier in my opinion.
Yeah.
Enter the Wu-Tang is absolute god tier.
Certainly.
A lot of the old like solo Wu-Tang stuff is great, especially the ODB shit.
Yeah.
Return to Texas
Everything by
is
Outkast is fucking amazing.
Outkast is great.
In my opinion, Illmatic not that good.
Illmatic sucks.
I wouldn't go as far to say that Illmatic sucks, but I agree that it's not that good.
I think it's a 7 to 8.
I agree, but shout out to my favorite line on Illmatic, not a bisexual, I'm an intellectual.
Yeah.
okay, here's a thought on Illmatic, right? It's not good because it's so fucking, like, lyrical. It's so lyrical. That's what makes it good. It has good beats and good flows, and to me, that's enough for it to be a good album.
I get it. I don't hate it.
I mean, I guess it's just, like, New York-style beats, so...
Let's look. I'm Googling classic hip hop albums. So Illmatic, we already talked about. Chronic, we already talked about. Reasonable Doubt.
Hold Us Back. I think Hold Us Back by Public Enemy is fucking amazing.
I agree.
A Reasonable Doubt by Jay-Z. What do you guys think?
I haven't heard it.
Don't like Jay-Z.
I think Jay-Z is fine. So I'd probably think that album is
pimp music.
My only experience with Jay-Z is when he's on Kanye songs, and I like Kanye, so you know. I have a generally positive opinion of him.
I think Jay-Z's alright.
I like Jay-Z when he's funny. I don't like Jay-Z when he's not funny.
Yeah, because like, when he's on, because when he's with Kanye, he's being funny because Kanye's fucking funny.
Yeah.
He's usually funny.
Ready to Die.
Ready to Die, classic.
Yeah, anything by Biggie is fucking classic. 10 out of 10.
Ready to Die, some of the songs on there are like, I don't know, like, it's real sad in the streets type hours.
Yeah.
Way better than anyone else has subsequently done it.
You look so good, I'll suck on your daddy's dick.
Yeah, that's a fucking literally. Biggie has done more for LGBT representation than Dorian Electra.
I remember my friend Chris. Shout out Young Dev.
Shout out Chris.
My longest IRL friend. Shout out you. Hope you're doing well. With binging Monogatari, which is, I guess is what you're doing now.
Hell yeah.
I remember talking to him. He was like, "Man, Biggie invented emo rap."
It's true.
You're actually right.
Actually, Ghetto Boys invented emo rap.
That is true. Ghetto Boys invented emo rap.
Actually, Boys to Men invented emo rap.
Actually, Boys on Boys on Boys.
Actually, okay, unironically, Bone Thugs and Harmony invented emo rap.
That's fair.
In terms of the stylistic traits.
Sure. But like the first rappers to like really be in their feelings were Ghetto Boys. Like they were the first ones to like be on wax talking about their fucking schizophrenic delusions.
Bug.
Misinterpretation of Lauryn Hill. Let's talk about it.
They're talking about what?
Not listen to it, Lauryn Hill.
You never listened to
me. Oh, I fuck with this album. I fuck with this album.
Yeah, that's one of the few albums, the classic albums I haven't heard.
Everyone loves it. And they love it for a reason. It holds up. It's amazing.
Yeah, I agree.
Lauryn Hill was completely fucked over by the entire music industry.
Yeah,
that is true.
Oh, absolutely.
It's one of the most fucked up.
People fucking shit on her her like MTV album where she produced, where she did a bunch of like completely original songs, and it's fucking great. But people don't like it because it's too raw and it's too fucking. It's too raw for them, but I fuck with that Lauryn Hill MTV singer-songwriter album where she was, like, fucked over by the music industry and everyone was calling her crazy and shit. It's a fucking pattern. They do it all the fucking time.
They do it to everyone. They fucked over No Thank You by getting his name wrong on the fucking
Kendrick's
album.
Yep. Deep lore.
Deep lore. For when No Thank You, about the motherfucking Hey Crush by Malice song, they got his name wrong like twice.
Yeah.
It's pretty base.
Yeah. Fuck all these rappers or whatever.
This is actually gonna be an announcement. Well, we're talking about me, the most important member of the Crab Stack. This is probably very premature, but no one's gonna watch this, so it doesn't matter. I'm playing a festival in February in Minecraft called Witherfest. So if you have a Minecraft account, show up to my set at Witherfest. I'm gonna be there. I forgot who, but a bunch of other cool people, hyperpop people, are gonna be there. If you're into the SoundCloud hyperpop scene, show up.
Sick.
That's sick as fuck.
Yeah,
I should get a Minecraft account so I can do a cameo.
Definitely.
Yeah. I bet it falls through. I bet with the fest is like turned out to be a scam, and like everyone fucking, it's like the fucking internet historian makes a video about it or something. I don't know.
Lol.
But for the moment, I'm pretty excited for that.
Hell yeah.
By the way, that was the last of the shitty hyped Twilight Realm section, so that's good.
We did it.
We got through the not as good part of the game, and now we can play the good part of the game.
But what are some other classic? What was the other?
Also, Straight Outta Compton.
Straight Outta Compton.
Oh yeah, Straight Outta Compton.
Straight Outta Compton. As much as I hate to admit it, Straight Outta Compton is pretty inconsistent.
I love the whole album personally. I think it's amazing.
Okay. Yeah.
It doesn't quite make my top 100, but it's still a really good
album. Also, okay, this isn't true post NWA, but NWA as a group, I feel like Eazy-E was my favorite member. I love Eazy-E so much.
Hell yeah.
He's like the whole thing about Eazy-E is just a fucking short pimpin' ass nigga.
He's pimpin'.
Yeah, and also Eazy-E made one of the best diss tracks ever, Real Motherfucking G's.
Hell yeah. That's
the second best diss track ever after Real Deli G's Fuck Suicide Squad.
Are you guys ready for the horror game? Are you ready for this game to become horror for a second?
Yeah, I fucking know this clip. I know this clip.
Yeah.
This shit gets fucking
orders. Tribe Called Quest. I think Low End Theory is better.
Midnight. Yeah, I agree. I flip flop a lot, but I think Low End Theory is better.
I don't like Tribe Called Quest.
But like a poor little Puerto Rican
hatred,
I go off in the Zulu Nation.
I listened to Midnight Marauders while driving through the Rocky Mountains, and I was like, "This is good."
I love Midnight Marauders. I like all the first three Tribe albums.
Same. I think they're good. Plunder, why don't you like them?
The betrayal. The betrayal.
I'm asking genuinely. I'm not saying you're bad.
I don't really know. I just know. I know I've listened. I listened to one of their. I forgot which one, but I listened to one of their albums fully, and I was like, "This is." I thought this is fine. I can understand. It's just not really my vibe.
Hey, no, thank you. Hey, no, thank you. Do you know albums with lyrics in them, right?
Yeah, I know about that mythical thing.
Yeah, do you know how Punter approaches lyrics? Oh no, thank you, Mutas.
This is so I had to fart. I thought better not fart.
Okay. Oh my god. Fucking...
I don't think that like the way that Tribe like approaches lyrics is like particularly anti-Plunder.
No, I think it's very pro Plunder because they their lyrics they're like MF Doom. They always like
I may like them on second listen because I don't have much experience with the Tribe Called Quest, in all honesty.
Tribe definitely one of the biggest definitely a proto Ralphingo type. What do you say they need to put together the proto Ralphingo kit?
Yeah,
I want to listen to the proto Ralphingo stuff.
Ralphingo is like, you know, it's sort of like, I'm very southern.
Yeah,
everything I do. But you have a lot. You have a bit more of that New York influence. You feel me?
Yeah,
more of that East Coast influence.
Yo, yeah, Aladdin looking faded.
At mixing together a lot of like East Coast and Southern type shit.
Yeah,
mostly. Because it's both really like both of those influences are really important to me.
Yeah, that's why your shit always sounds so dynamic.
Yeah, that's why I'm very dynamic.
Speaking of our albums,
what the fuck? What are we looking at?
Video games.
Yo,
you know.
High as fuck, bro. That nigga had the motherfucking. That nigga looked like Ruth. No, like, that nigga had a slick face.
This game was rated T, you know.
That's true.
We still had to get through my albums first. We still had to get through
my albums. Yashi Base Part 4. Talk about Yashi Base Part 4.
Yashi Base Part 4.
No, I want to talk about Mobb Deep.
Let's Hold talk on. About
Mobb Deep, I don't care about anyone who is my friend. I don't care about rappers who aren't my friends.
Mobb Deep made the best. Mobb Deep made Shook Ones Part 2, which is the best 90s hip hop song ever made. It's the archetypical 90s hip hop song, and the album is not that good. But that particular song is the best 90s hip hop song.
Okay, to finish up the fucking dose, all right. Yoshi Bass Volume 3. I listened to it while face down on my bed, sad. It's good. I like it. Very nice. Yoshi Bass Volume 4, definitely the best volume.
It's Yoshi Bass 4 is just me coping with a mixed episode. It's mixed episode cope music.
Yeah, and I like cope music. Tonal Whiplash, dedicated to my friend Lily, silly. Yeah, is a fucking amazing song. Shout out Osaka Syndrome.
Shout out.
Who's a member of Crowd Stacking, though she hasn't showed up to anything yet. However, she will. She's just shy. It's okay. Volume 5 is, I haven't listened to Volume 5 yet because I don't think I'm ready for Volume 5.
Mm. Volume 5 is a Toots Might XRL thing album secretly.
Oh, yeah, wow.
Much
like Bush by Snoop Dogg is secretly a Pharrell Snoop Dogg project. This is secretly because it's all produced by me.
Yeah.
I gave her a lot of like pre-Anlo Dempamod beats. Like, wow. Before I was like on the internet, like these are like a lot of them are like old beats.
That's very impressive.
Which is that I think they work for you because a lot of them are a lot kookier.
And kooky.
Yeah, there's a bunch of kooky beats. There's a bunch of kooky beats in this album. It's fucking amazing. It's amazing. It's great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm very excited for the finished product. Great. I'm gonna listen to it all the way through one day.
Yeah, when Yoshi Beast, is all over. Yeah. I think that's
Yoshi Beast is gonna be like 3 hours when it's done.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, Simon, album.
No.
Oh.
No.
Okay.
Should we cut the episode here now?
No, thank you.
No, thank you. Because before we talk about, I kind of want to do it in like semi-chronological, because I want to talk about Ralph Ingo Loves You.
Okay, well, we're going to talk about Ralph Ingo albums. Well, first you have to talk about Vamp Girl music, then we can talk about Ingo stuff that has come out since then.
Yeah.
But first we should probably cut the episode first.
We're at like in an hour 5, so that's, the end of the third episode.
Yeah.
So,
okay, next time. Episode.
Yeah.
Next time on Cum Grumps.
Cum Grumps.